In this video, we're deriving a power reduction formula for the integral of secant to the nth power. And this formula turns out to be huge, but the main point here is that on the right-hand side, we have the integral of secant to the n minus second power. In other words, a lower power of the secant function and therefore a simpler integral to handle. And we're going to get this done by using integration by parts. But it's not a simple case for integration by parts. It's one of those cases where integration by parts produces a copy of the original integral on the right-hand side, and we have to gather that together with the original integral. So we'll go ahead and start with our original integral, secant to the n, x dx. And if I'm going to attempt to use integration by parts on this, I need a piece that's easy to guess the antiderivative of. So I immediately think, oh, I could use a secant squared for that because the antiderivative is just the tangent function. So we're going to split off a secant squared, and I end up with secant to the n minus 2 of x times secant squared x dx. So now when we set up our integration by parts, we're going to let secant squared x dx be dv, and then the other piece is u. So we say let u equals secant to the n minus 2 of x, and then we have to find the differential of that. So du is going to require the chain rule here. We bring down that power of n minus 2, and we subtract 1 from our original exponent. That's just applying the power rule to the secant function. And then we have to multiply by the derivative of the secant function, which is secant x tangent x. And I'll go ahead and clean that up just a little bit. We notice that we have a secant x right next to secant to the n minus 3, and that gives us secant to the n minus 2. So du is n minus 2 secant to the n minus 2 of x times tangent x. Now we make our substitution for dv, that was secant squared x dx. And again, our whole motivation here was to split off a piece where the antiderivative was pretty simple. So v is going to be the antiderivative of secant squared, which is just the tangent function. So now we apply the integration by parts formula. And remember, everything we're doing here is a modification of this original integral, secant to the n x dx. So this integral becomes u times v, so that's secant to the n minus 2 of x times tangent x, then minus the integral of v du. And du is this long expression right here. I need to multiply that by another factor of tangent. So I'm going to move the constant out in front of this integral. That was an n minus 2 attached to the du. So I end up with an n minus 2 integral of tangent x times secant to the n minus 2 times another tangent x. So that's secant to the n minus 2 x tangent squared x dx. So this term out in front is a spectator. And we realize in this integral that tangent squared has a Pythagorean identity. We can rewrite that as secant squared minus 1. And the reason that's promising is that when we distribute over this first term, we're going to get a copy of the original integral, secant to the nth x. So we replace tangent squared with secant squared minus 1. And then in the next step, we're going to go ahead and do this distributing. And while I work on this, I'm going to go ahead and split it into two different integrals. So the first one, I have a minus n minus 2 times the integral of secant to the nth x dx. Our second term has a secant to the n minus 2, but with a minus sign in front. But when I apply this constant that was out in front of the entire integral, I end up with a plus, and it's a plus n minus 2 times the integral of secant to the n minus 2 x dx. And so we're starting to see some encouraging things here. I have an integral of secant to the n minus 2 of x, and a constant of n minus 2 out in front of it. So it's starting to look a bit like that last piece of our power reduction formula. And I have a copy of the original integral. And we're used to using this idea when we use the integration by parts looping trick. Everything that I have written in this last line is a result of modifying the original integral secant to the nth x. And there's one term in there with an integral of secant to the nth x. So we can add that to both sides. And now on the left-hand side, I'm adding an n minus 2 times the integral of secant to the nth of x. So this gives me a total of 1 plus n minus 2 times that integral. And on the right-hand side, I have this leading term, secant to the n minus 2 of x times tangent x. And I notice that our goal here is to get a term that looks like this, like a sine function times a secant function. So I'm going to go ahead and replace the tangent with a sine over cosine and see what happens. And then our second term on the right-hand side is an n minus 2 times the integral of secant to the n minus 2x dx. So now simplifying the left-hand side, 1 plus n minus 2, that's n minus 1 times our original integral. And then just to deal with this cosine issue, 1 over the cosine is the secant. So one factor of secant multiplying secant to the n minus 2 gives me a secant to the n minus 1 times sine x. And I'll go ahead and write it with the sine x out in front just because that's what we're going for in the power reduction formula. So I get sine x secant to the n minus 1 x plus an n minus 2 times the integral of secant to the n minus 2 x dx. So it looks like we've got it at this point. All I have to do is divide by the n minus 1 that's out in front of our integral of secant to the nth power. And we find that the integral of secant to the nth power is 1 over n minus 1 sine x secant to the n minus 1 x plus n minus 2 over n minus 1 integral of secant to the n minus 2 x dx. Now, I'm personally not a very big fan of using formulas like this, but I do like to throw the derivations onto exams as a bonus problem. So the derivation here required a clever use of integration by parts. So seeing how to split up that integrand so we got a piece that was easy to integrate. Then we had to use a Pythagorean trigonometric identity and recognize a copy of the original integral. These are all really important skills. And honestly, if you have all of those important skills, you can handle the integral of secant to the nth power by just applying those skills on a case-by-case basis. Because I don't think it's practical to try to like memorize these giant power reduction formulas. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.